Okay. Back at High Hrothgar. Now the next question, of course, is where are we going to find Arngeir? That is an excellent question. I'll let you know if I see anyone. Please and thank you. I don't even know where anyone would be. You know, neither would I. However, there are plenty of hallways. Right. Okay, where do we start? Start this way. Good plan. Oh, there's a staircase back here. Just missed it. Yep. Correct. Oh, hello! Which one of you is this Arngeir?
Sky, guard you.
There you are. So... it's been a bit of a journey. And we've just discovered that I need to learn the shout used to defeat Alduin.
Where did you learn of that? Who have you been talking to?
It was recorded on Alduin's wall. I get the feeling that... perhaps I'm not supposed to know about that.
The Blades, of course. They specialize in meddling in matters they barely understand. Their reckless arrogance knows no bounds.
They have always sought to turn the Dragonborn from the path of wisdom. Have you learned nothing from us? Would you simply be a tool in the hands of the Blades to be used for their own purposes?
Well, right at the moment, I feel as though defeating Alduin sort of is a bit higher of a priority than just being anybody's tool, really.
What I want is irrelevant. This shout was used once before, was it not? And here we are again. Have you considered that Alduin was not meant to be defeated? Those who overthrew him in ancient times only postponed the day of reckoning. They did not stop it. If the world is meant to end, so be it. Let it end and be reborn.
Arngeir? Look, Alduin is not the only one who wants the world to be destroyed and rebuilt in his image. So you won't help me then?
No, not now. Not until you return to the path of wisdom.
Arngeir, Rock Lostovaki, Strundul, Rock Fentinvak, Paarthurnax.
Dragonborn, wait. Forgive me, I was intemperate. I allowed my emotions to cloud my judgment. Master Einarth reminded me of my duty. The decision whether or not to help you is not mine to make.
That is, I think, the wise answer. So, can you teach me the shout?
No, I cannot teach it to you, because I do not know it. It is called Dragonrend, but its words of power are unknown to us. We do not regret this loss. Dragonrend holds no place within the way of the voice.
Great. What's so bad about it?
It was created by those who had lived under the unimaginable cruelty of Alduin's dragon cult. Their whole lives were consumed with hatred for dragons, and they poured all their anger and hatred into this shout.
When you learn a shout, you take it into your very being. In a sense, you become the shout. In order to learn and use this shout, you will be taking this evil into yourself.
You are telling me that the rage of living under tyrants is evil. I'm not sure I agree with you. But that doesn't matter if the shout is lost. If that's the case, how can I possibly defeat Alduin?
Only Paarthurnax, the master of our order, can answer that question, if he so chooses.
Okay. And who is this?
He is our leader. He surpasses us all in his mastery of the way of the voice.
I'll need to speak with him then.
You weren't ready. You still aren't ready. But, thanks to the blades, you now have questions that only Paarthurnax can answer.
In that case, why haven't I met him yet?
He lives in seclusion on the very peak of the mountain. He speaks to us only rarely, and never to outsiders. Being allowed to see him is a great privilege.
Okay. So all I need to do is climb to the top of the mountain then, I take it?
Only those whose voice is strong can find the path. We will teach you a shout to open the way to Paarthurnax.
All right. I'm sorry, that was probably intemperate of me. Frankly, I think you're in the right. Given where you came from, at any rate. Thank you for the vote of confidence, Smith. Are you all right? Oh, I think so. Why? Oh, it's just... You seem... irritated lately. Well... Maybe it's just... a delayed reaction to losing my sight. And my home. And everything. Well, go on then. I don't blame you. Right. Where have they gone? You know that fire? Ah. It would be helpful if they weren't all so quiet, but that's a rock. But... Alright, here I am. There are words carved into the ground on the far side of the fire. Thank you, Myth. In fairness to them, I suppose, they do sort of rattle the ground with their shouts, so...
I will grant you my understanding of clear skies. This is your final gift from us, Dragonborn. Use it well. Clear skies will blow away the mist, but only for a time. The path to Paarthurnax is perilous, not to be embarked upon lightly. Keep moving, stay focused on your goal, and you will reach the summit.
Oh, great. There is little that I can think of that is more dangerous than climbing a perilous mountain blind. Well, at least you have me with you. At least I have you with me. Oh. Oh. Well, I don't think I need to, guess. No. You may have lost your sight, but your sense of hearing and touch are still intact. Indeed. And that is cold, cold wind. Right.
Look!
All right. Now we go. Stay close, Myth.
I will. There's more fog up here.
All right. Oh, there it is.
Look!
Oh, that's helpful. Sort of. I can see where the light is, anyway. Good.
Look!
That is terrifying, I hope you know. It's certainly something. Is that Ken? Oh, you can see that. If I stand in just the right spot, yes.
Look!
What is that?
Ice Wraith.
Alright.
Damn, things would be impossible to shoot at.
Indeed. There we are.
Look.
I should probably keep this out.
Potentially, yes. So when Arngir says you become the Shout, what exactly... Ice Wraith.
Come on.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Look.
As I was going to ask, what exactly does it feel like?
Oh, shouting?
Yeah.
It does depend on the shout.
Look.
And honestly, I've never quite thought about it. But clear skies is... It's kind of warm, actually. Are you keeping up?
Normally it's me asking that question. I'm fine. Oh. Dead goat.
Right. Clear skies is warm. It's a bit like... I hear an ice wraith. It's a bit like... a nice summer's day in Shimmering. Oh, maybe a... a nice day in the wet season, anyway. What did I just walk over?
I'm not sure you ought to know.
I'm going to guess it's a dead body.
Right. You are correct. You keeping up?
I am indeed.
Don't worry about me. Although, in fairness, it is getting a bit difficult to breathe up here. No kidding. I don't mind taking breaks or stopping to rest if you need it. It is admittedly getting a bit hard for me to breathe up here as well. I'm amazed an old man can live all the way up here. Well, you know Nords. I will be surprised if he isn't a Nord. They will live in the most inhospitable places imaginable. Namely, most of Skyrim. You have a good point. What does that make Dunmer? Less cold hardy. Fair enough. Right, less talking. More hiking. That?
No.
Oh, ouch. Standing in that cold. I've been alright with most of the cold so far, but that was, bit much. Even with this armor. Huh. That sun feels very good. Indeed. Oh! Uh-oh. There it is.
Dremyolok. Greetings, Wunderneek. I am Paarthurnax. Who are you? What brings you to my Strunmach, my mountain?
Well, it's not attacking. Uh-huh. I wasn't expecting you to be a dragon. Although with that name, I probably should have.
I am as my father Akatosh made me, as are you, Dovahkiin. Tell me, why do you come here, Volan? Why do you intrude on my meditation?
I didn't mean to interrupt, but I need to learn the dragon wrench out. Can you teach me?
Drem. Patience. There are formalities which must be observed at the first meeting of two of the Dove. By long tradition, the elder speaks first. Hear my thum. Feel it in your bones. Match it if you are Dovahkiin. I have spoken. The Rotmulag waits.
The... what? He carved a new rune onto that dragon stone over there. Oh!
The word calls you. Go to it.
Thank you, Paarthurnax. Ah, this...
A gift, Dovahkiin. Yol, understand fire as the Dove do. Now, show me what you can do. Greet me not as elf, but as Dovah.
Okay.
Come, Dovahkiin, Ninyol, strike me with the fire of your thum.
Yol!
Ah, yes, Sosedo Vlostmul, the dragon blood runs strong in you. It is long since I had the pleasure of speech with one of my own kind.
That felt sort of pathetic to me, but...
So, you have made your way here to me. No easy task for a jaw, mortal. Even for one of Dovasos, dragon blood. What would you ask of me?
I would ask to learn the dragon wrench shout, if you know it.
Ah, I have expected you, Proda. You would not come all this way for Tinvak with an old Dova. No, you seek your weapon against Alduin.
Right. The Greybeards didn't want me to come to you at all.
Yes. They are very protective of me, Bahlan Fadon. But I do not know the Thum you seek. Krosis, it cannot be known to me. Your kind, Jor, mortals, created it as a weapon against the Dove, the dragons. Our Hadrime, our minds, cannot even comprehend its concepts.
Okay. How can I learn it, then?
Drem, all in good time. First, a question for you. Why do you want to learn this, Thum?
Because I need to stop Alduin. I like this world and I don't want it to end.
Prusa. As good a reason as any. There are many who feel as you do, although not all. Some would say that all things must end so that the next can come to pass. Perhaps this world is simply the egg of the next Kalpa, Lin Vokin. Would you stop the next world from being born?
For the moment, yes. And not to be rude, but I didn't come all this way to debate philosophy with a dragon.
You have much to learn of the Dove, then. There is nothing else but philosophy to a Dova. It is no accident that we do battle with our Thum, our voices. There is no distinction between debate and combat to a dragon. Tinvak Losgra. For us, it is one and the same. But you have indulged my weakness for speech long enough. Krosis, now I will answer your question. Do you know why I live here, at the peak of the Monaven, what you name Throat of the World?
I never thought about it, actually. And that does explain some things.
This is the most sacred mountain in Skyrim, Zokrovak Struma, the great mountain of the world. Here, the ancient tongues, the first mortal masters of the voice, brought Alduin to battle and defeated him.
Using the dragon wren shout, I assume?
Yes and no, Viknus Nikaron. Alduin was not truly defeated either. If he was, you would not be here today seeking to defeat him. The Nords of those days used the Dragonrend shout to cripple Alduin, but this was not enough. Ok Mulag Unslad. It was the Kel, the Elder Scroll. They used it to cast him adrift on the currents of time.
An Elder Scroll? And are you saying that the ancient Nords sent Alduin forward in time?
Not intentionally. Some hoped he would be gone forever. Forever lost. Meye. I knew better. Tidbo Amativ. Time flows ever onward. One day, he would surface. Which is why I have lived here. For thousands of mortal years, I have waited. I knew where he would emerge, but not when.
Okay. That's a lot. How does any of it help me?
Tid Krent. Time was shattered here because of what the ancient Nords did to Alduin. If you brought that Kel, that Elder Scroll, back here to the Tid Ahran, the Time Wound, with the Elder Scroll that was used to break time, you may be able to cast yourself back to the other end of the break. You could learn Dragonrend from those who created it.
Oh boy. All right. Do you know where I can find an Elder Scroll?
Krosis, no. I know little of what has passed below in the long years I have lived here. You are likely better informed than I.
great. So, ideas?
Esben Arangir might have some idea.
It's a good point.
Trust your instincts, Dovahkiin. Your blood will show you the way.
I hope so. What do I do with the Elder Scroll once I find it?
Return it here, to the Tid Ahran. Then, Kele Vomindok. Nothing is certain with such things. But I believe the scroll's bond with the Tid Ahran will allow you a seeing, a vision of the moment of its creation. Then you will feel, know, Dragonrend in the power of its first expression. You will see them, Wuthfadon, my friends, Haken, Gormlaith, Feldir.
Setting aside the whole visions and sight thing for the moment, Haken, Gormlaith, and Feldir, who are they?
The first mortals that I taught the Thum, the first tongues, the leaders of the rebellion against Alduin. They were mighty in their day, even to attempt to defeat Alduin. Sahrothun, the Nords have had many heroes since, but none greater.
Okay. Cira? Yes? It is a bit dark out, and I
assume you've noticed how cold it's gotten. Indeed. Thank you for the tinvark, Paarthurnax.
Dremyolok, greetings. Lokthum.
Gods, that's bitter. Wow. Right, this was a mistake. Yes. It's dark out. I cannot see anything. Which is, I mean, you know. But night blindness is worse. Don't worry, we'll get back down the mountain. Uh-huh. I should probably... ready the fog be gone. Okay. Basically just follow where the wind isn't. Essentially. Do you think you're ready to fight Alduin? Absolutely not. Which is sort of going to be a problem. Oh gods. Downhill is worse. Downhill is so much worse. You're fine, Cira. Okay, we'll talk about Alduin later. Right now, I'm just going to focus on getting down the mountain without either freezing or falling. Oh, like that. Almost there. I can tell, we're on the Iverstead Bridge right now, aren't we? We are. I still think that we potentially should have stayed at the monastery, but... I mean, maybe. But it's warmer down here, and... I don't know, maybe we could ask around and see if anybody knows about Elder Scrolls and whatnot. I mean, I doubt it, but... Right. Defeating Alduin. That's the other thing. Yeah, I have no idea. I also don't have any idea where I am right now.
Oh. I fear the night, because the werewolves and vampires don't. What is it?
I'm a little bit lost. Where's the inn? It's behind you.
Don't think you can barter with me like I'm one of those damn shopkeepers.
Oh, no. That wasn't my intention at all. I'm just... Nords. Indeed.
You there.
Oh.
The Dawnguard is looking for anyone willing to fight against the growing vampire menace. What do you say?
The what guard? Hold on. Where did you go?
Yeah? You change your mind? The Dawnguard could use somebody like you.
What is the Dawnguard?
We're vampire hunters. We search out and destroy those blood-sucking scum wherever we find them.
I haven't noticed any vampire menace. But the guard said something about both werewolves and vampires, so I assume that this is something that should be noticeable.
You're not paying attention then, like almost everyone else around here. Haven't you heard that the Hall of the Vigilance was destroyed by vampires? They never took the threat seriously, and now they paid the price.
Vigilance? What are you talking about?
The Vigilance mostly hunt down Daedra worshippers, which is why they got torn to pieces when they went up against vampires. That's why our leader, Ezron, is re-establishing the Dawnguard. Real, serious vampire hunters.
Okay. Cira? Yes, Myth? Count us in.
Ha! Ezron's going to like you. Go talk to him at Fort Dawnguard, southeast of Riften. He'll decide if you're Dawnguard material.
What? Well, this is sudden. What is this about?
Well, they're in the Rift. So, first of all, they're nearby. Second of all... You aren't sure if you're strong enough to defeat Alduin.
True. You're thinking that they could potentially teach me some things.
Potentially. We won't know until we get over there, of course.
Of course. Right, can we go somewhere where there's at least a little bit more light?
Of course, go on.
Welcome to the Villamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Pardon me, my lady. Would you care to hear me play my lute?
Maybe later.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
Oh, I'm sure. We're actually looking to rent a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Excuse me, madam.
I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Is everything all right?
If you fancy a bit of music, let me know.
Oh, nothing.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Are you being flirted with?
Well, I wouldn't... Speak, elf.
I wouldn't go that far. Right. I was not paying attention.
Another batch of logs completely ruined. I swear these bears have it out for me.
I hardly think the bears are clever enough to hold a grudge against you, Miss Temba.
When I want your opinion, I'll ask for it. Otherwise, mind your business.
Why don't we go outside, actually? Oh no, they've quieted down. So, the Dawn Guard?
Well, of course.
Well, not of course, but I think it's a good idea.
You know me, I'm good at killing things. Vampires shouldn't be too difficult.
But... yes, we are going outside. Come on! Right, I don't know where to go, but somewhere secluded?
Basically anywhere off a main road.
Uh-huh, and that would be where, exactly?
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.
Oh, ouch. That sounds deeply unpleasant.
There's a graveyard.
Oh, well... I suppose that's... appropriate. Myth?
Yes?
You are a Daedra worshipper.
And?
It's not like I'm a follower of Sheogorath or something. But you're still a Daedra worshipper. And I'm going to guess that the Dawn Guard aren't going to take kindly to somebody who... Who do you worship again?
Mephala, Boethia, and Azura. And I doubt they would take too horribly to Azura. She's supposed to be one of the nice ones, as far as everyone else is concerned.
It's the other two that worry me. The Prince of Plots and... whatever it is that Mephala does.
Whoever it is Mephala does.
What?
Nothing.
Right. But you think that I could learn something from them?
That? And they might potentially... come in handy.
or what? Oh, who knows? Diplomatic favors. Maybe they know where to find an Elder Scroll. Either way, we should look into it. I think you're right. I do think you're right. Didn't Paarthurnax say that something something blood will guide you? I would have hoped that you were paying more attention to that than I was. I was somewhat preoccupied trying not to freeze. Sorry about that. It's fine. The inn is warm enough. Indeed. Right. Did you happen to get the location of this Fort Dawnguard? Well. Oh, we're doomed. Well. Maybe. But we're doomed together. Right, let's just turn in for the night. I saw that smile. Don't you dare, Mithidros.